Welcome to the lesson on machine module. Machine module in MicroPython provides access to various hardware related functionalities of the microcontrollers. So we can work with ESP32 and other hardware platforms as well. So it provides access to GPIO pins, means you can control GPIO pins, you can read the GPIO pins. It provides access to analog to digital converters, digital to analog converters, and also it facilitates communication interfaces like I2C communication, SPI communication, UART communication, timers, RTC, and many more. Now I'll be showing you how we can access GPIO pins, means how to read or how to write from the GPIO pins. I'll be showing you now. Connect ESP32 to the computer or laptop using micro USB cable. Please connect like this, all of you. Please follow these steps. Right, so we have connected ESP32 to the computer. Now search for Tony. Now ensure that, you know, go to run and check whether interpreter is MicroPython ESP32 and port is selected. So these two should be selected, all of you, and click OK. Right, now you should be able to see MicroPython. Now I'm going to control onboard LED. We know onboard LED, right? In ESP32 microcontroller, we have onboard LED at pin number 2. Now we want to control LED connected to this particular pin. To control means, for example, you have the LED connected to pin number 2. Now we want to turn off this LED. To turn on and to turn off this LED, first we have to make this pin 2 as output pin. We have to make it as output. Once you make this as output, then we have to write high to turn on or low to turn off, right? So I'll be showing you how we can do this by using machine module. So all of you, please import machine. After importing machine module, now we will check what are the various classes present in machine. Use dir method, dir machine, and press enter. Now we can see there are different classes provided by this particular machine module. So what are they? We can see ADC, analog to digital converter class, DAC, digital to analog converter class, I2C, I2S, pulse width modulation, pin module. So this pin module is useful for controlling GPIO pins, or to access the GPIO pins we are going to use. So we'll be using this pin class present in machine to control GPIO pins. And we have RTC class for real-time clock, and also there are other classes also available. Now I will be showing you how to work with this pin class to control GPIO pins. Now we are going to control pin number 2. For doing this, let us create an instance. LED is equal to machine is the module name dot pin P capital in, and now you have to pass here the pin number. So the pin number is 2, and then we want to make this pin as output. Okay, so machine.pin dot out. So now this pin LED, we configured it as output pin. Now we can turn on the LED by using LED dot on, then LED will be on, right? Now we can see onboard LED is on. Same way, LED dot off, then LED will be off. This onboard LED is off now. This is how you can control onboard LED. So by using machine module. Now to blink the LED, we are going to write a program. So it's a very simple program. Suppose we connected LED to pin number 2, external LED. How to write a blink program? We know what is the blinking of an LED. Blinking of LED is simple. Turn on LED, wait for some time, turn off LED, and wait for some time. And we have to repeat this entire procedure. Okay, so we have to repeat these 4 lines. On, wait, off, wait. So if you are, infinite times, if you are running this, actually this is actually blinking of LED. Blinking of LED. So now I'll be showing you how to write a program for doing this. First we have to import machine. Then all of you create LED object from the class pin. LED is equal to machine.pin, pin number 2, comma, machine.pin.out. Now we are going to create infinite loop because we want to continuously turn on and wait, turn off and wait. We want to blink continuously. For doing this, we have to write infinite loop while true. So the loop will be running forever. Now within this LED.on, now we have to provide waiting time. For providing the waiting time, we have to import uTime module. Import uTime. In uTime, we have a method called as sleep. uTime.sleep. We are going to provide 2 seconds delay here. uTime.sleep 2 seconds. So the program will wait here for 2 seconds. And then LED.off. And again, we want to wait for 2 seconds in the off state. So uTime.sleep 2 seconds, right? LED will be on, waits for 2 seconds, LED will be off, and then waits for 2 seconds, and the loop will be repeating, right, all of you? Now you can run this program. So there is syntax error in line number 3. Yeah, so actually this is comma, 2 comma machine.pin.out. Okay, all of you, LED is equal machine.pin, 2 comma machine.pin.out. Run this program now. Now the program is running. Now we can see that onboard LED is blinking. LED is on and waits for 2 seconds. LED will be off and waits for 2 seconds. Right, all of you. So thank you so much